नमस्कार माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द लेक्चर सीरीज ऑफ मशीन डिजाइन। नाउ इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू सॉल्व सम एग्जांपल्स ऑफ द एंटी फ्रिक्शन बेयरिंग और बॉल बेयरिंग। नाउ लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द एग्जांपल नंबर वन। डिजाइन अ सेल्फ अलाइनिंग बॉल बेयरिंग फॉर अ रेडियल लोड ऑफ 7000 न्यूटन and a thrust load of 2100 newton. The desired life of the bearing is 160 million revolution at 300 rpm. Assume uniform and steady load. The value of x and y factors are 0.65 and 3.5 respectively. The outer ring rotates. So we have to find the we have to design the self-aligning ball bearing. That means we have to find out the dynamic load carrying capacity of the bearing. Okay. So first of all, given data, radial load is 7000 newton, axial load FA is equal to 2100 newton, L is a 160 million revolutions, okay, and life means 160 million revolutions, and is the speed is 300 rpm, S is equal to 1, yeah, and X factor is equal to 0.65, Y factor is equal to 3.5, and here outer ring is rotates, so therefore V factor, which is depends upon the race, so V is equal to 1.2. okay, now first of all let us find out the equivalent bearing load. Okay, so we have to first of find out the equivalent bearing load. Okay, so that equivalent bearing load, which is PE, so PE is equal to S, okay, X into V into FR plus Y into FA. Okay, we know that equation of the equivalent bearing load. Now we have assumed here the uniform and steady load, so therefore value of S, okay, S is equal to service factor is equal to 1, and X is equal to 0.65 into V is equal to 1.2 into 7000, okay, plus Y is equal to 3.5 and FA is equal to 2100. Okay, so therefore the equivalent bearing load is equal to 12,810 newton. This is the equivalent bearing load. Now we have to find the life of the bearing. Okay, find the dynamic load capacity. So for that we know that the life of the bearing, okay, life L is equal to, you know that the C by PE upon P. Okay, so life is equal to, you know that the 160 million revolution. Okay, so therefore is equal to C divided by PE. We have already found 12,810 raised to P is equal to 3, ball bearing. So for ball bearing, value of small p is equal to 3. Okay, so therefore from that we can say the dynamic load capacity of this bearing is equal to, you can find it is 69543.38 newton. Okay, so this is our answer, dynamic load carrying capacity of the bearing. Okay, this is our answer. Now let us solve the example number 2. It is required to select a ball bearing suitable for 50 mm diameter shaft rotating at 1500 rpm. The radial and thrust loads at the bearing are 4500 newton and 1600 newton respectively. The value of x and y factors are 0.56 and 1.2 respectively. Select a proper ball bearing from following table for rotating life of 22,500 hours. The inner ring rotates and service factor is 1. Okay, now here you can see given number, bearing number, okay, and dynamic load capacity is given. Okay, so if the dynamic load carrying capacity 21,600, then bearing number is 6010, then 35,100, 6210, 61,800, 6310, and 87,100 when bearing number 6410. Okay, so first of all, given data. Okay, so diameter D is equal to 50 mm. Then speed N is equal to 1500 rpm. Radial load is equal to 4500 newton. Axial load is equal to 1600 newton. X factor is equal to 0.56. Y is equal to 1.2. And life in hours is 22,500 hours. And here inner ring rotates. So therefore value of V is equal to 1 and service factor is equal to 1. S is equal to 1. So first of all, we have to find out the dynamic load carrying capacity of the bearing. And from that, okay, we have to select the bearing number. So for to find out the dynamic load carrying capacity, first of all, we have to find the equivalent bearing load. Okay, now here for that the life is in hours, so we have to find the life in million revolution. Okay, then find the equivalent bearing load and then find the dynamic load carrying capacity. Now as we know that the equation, okay, equation for the relation between the million revolution life and our life, so L is equal to here this L, okay, life in million revolution, L is equal to LH into 60 into N divided by 10^6. Okay, so therefore LH is equal to 22,500 into 60 into 1500 divided by 10^6. Okay, so now let us find what is the value of L in million revolution. So therefore L in million revolution, okay, by you will find it is 2025 million revolutions. Okay, 2025 million revolution. Now let us find the equivalent bearing load. So you know that the equivalent bearing load PE is equal to X, okay, into V into FR plus Y into FA. Okay, so S is equal to service factor is equal to 1, X is equal to 0.56, V is equal to 1, and FR radial load is equal to 4500 plus Y is equal to, you know that it is 1.2 into FA 1600. Okay, so from that we can say equivalent bearing load is equal to 4440 newton. Okay, 4440 newton. Now We know that the equation for the life of the bearing. Okay. So L is equal to C upon PE raised to small p. So we have already defined that life is equal to 2025 million revolution divide is equal to C upon PE 4440 raised to 3. Okay, so from that we can say the dynamic load carrying capacity, you will find the 56,172.6 newton. Okay, now from that we have to find the standard value from the table corresponding to this value. Okay, now see here our diameter is 50. Okay, diameter is 50, so from that we have to find the bearing. Okay, right, so here the corresponding dynamic load carrying capacity. Okay, then we have to find the corresponding dynamic load carrying capacity. So that is our dynamic load carrying capacity is 56,172. Now in this table, okay, in this table the 56,172, so the corresponding load carrying capacity is 61,800. Okay, dynamic load carrying capacity is equal to 61,800 corresponding to the 56,172.6. Okay, so from that we can say from the table, we can say from table the value of C, the value of C is equal to 61,800 newton. Okay, now here you can see in this table the 61,800 newton, so corresponding bearing number is equal to 6310. Okay, so therefore we can say bearing number is equal to 6310. Okay, so by this way you can find the bearing number. Now example number 3, a single row deep groove ball bearing number 6002 is subjected to an axial thrust of 1000 newton and a radial load of 2200 newton. Find the expected life that 50% of the bearings will complete under this condition. Okay, static load capacity C0 is equal to 2500 newton and dynamic load capacity C is equal to 5590 newton. Okay, now given data, radial load is equal to 2200 newton, axial load is equal to 1000 newton, static load carrying capacity is equal to 2500 newton and dynamic load carrying capacity is equal to 5590 newton. Okay, so here we have to find the L50 life. Okay, because the 50% of the bearing will complete under this condition, so therefore we have to find the L50 life. Okay, so for that, first of all, we have to find the L10 life, L, okay, in million revolution, then you can find the L50 life. Okay, so for that, let us assume here the value of X, Y, S and V are not given. Okay, so you have to assume the value of X, Y. Okay, so not given, so generally assume value of X is equal to 0.56. okay, then Y is equal to 1. Okay, then service factor S is equal to 1 and V is equal to also 1. Assume that the inner race is rotating, so value of V is equal to 1. Now find out the equivalent bearing load. Okay, so therefore equivalent bearing load, you know that the equation of the equivalent bearing load, PE is equal to S X V FR plus Y into FA. So put the value here, S is equal to 1, X is equal to 0.56, V is equal to 1. Then FR is equal to 2200 plus Y is equal to 1 into 1000. Okay. So therefore the equivalent bearing load, okay, value of the equivalent bearing load is equal to 2312 Newton. Now life of the bearing, okay, life of the bearing, that is the L is equal to C upon PE raised to P. Okay, so therefore you know that the dynamic load carrying capacity is given, so it is 5590 upon 2312 raised to 3. Okay, so therefore from that you can find it is 14.13 million revolutions. Okay, now let us find the 50% of bearing will complete under this condition. So L50 life, so for to find out the L50 life, so L50 is equal to 5 into L10, okay, 5 into L10. So therefore you can say 5 into 14.13. So therefore L50 life is equal to 70.65 million revolutions. Okay. So this is our answer, 70.65 million revolution is our answer. Now let us solve the next example. Example number 4. A single row deep groove ball bearing 6010 is subjected to an axial thrust of 1200 Newton and a radial load of 2400 Newton. Find the expected life that the 50% of bearing will complete under this condition. Static load carrying capacity is equal to 13,200 Newton and dynamic load carrying capacity is equal to 21,600 Newton. Okay, now here table is given. Okay, ratio of FA by C0, okay, and FA by FR is greater than E, then the value of X and Y are given. Okay, value of E is equal to 0.27, 0.31. If FA upon FR is less than E, then the value of X and Y are given. Okay, so first of all, we have to find the ratio of FA upon C0, FA upon FR. Okay, so then here you can see the value of FA is equal to 1200, FR is equal to 2400. C0 and C are given. So now let us find first of all FA upon C0. So FA is equal to 1200 and C0 is equal to 13,200. So therefore FA upon C0 is equal to 0.09. Okay. Now related E. Okay, related E is equal to what? 0.09. Okay, value is, so therefore here related E, you can say related E is equal to, you can see FA upon C0 is equal to 0.9. So is in between here 0.07, 0.09. So 0.07 and 0.13. So we have to consider this value 0.13. So corresponding value of E is equal to 0.31. So related E is equal to 0.31. Okay. Now let us find the FA upon FR. So value of FA upon FR is equal to 1200 upon 2400 is equal to 0.5. Okay. So from that we can say FA upon FR is 0.5 and E is equal to 0.35. So therefore we can say FA upon FR is greater than E. Okay, FA upon FR is greater than E, right? So we have to consider this table. FA upon FR is greater than E here. So therefore, from that you can find the value of X and Y. So corresponding value of X and Y is given here, right? So now let us find the value of X and Y. So from table, you can say from table, X is equal to 0.56. Okay. Then Y is equal to 1.4. Okay. Y is equal to 1.4. And take S is equal to 1 and V is equal to. Okay, now let us find the equivalent bearing load. Okay, so therefore the equivalent bearing load PE, equivalent bearing load PE is equal to, you know that, S X into V into FR plus Y into FA. So put the value S is equal to 1, X is equal to 0.56, V is equal to 1, FR is equal to 2400 plus Y is equal to 1.4, FA is equal to 1200. So therefore equivalent bearing load is equal to 3024 Newton. Now life of the bearing, L is equal to, you know that equation, E upon PE raised to small p. Okay, so therefore we can see dynamic load carrying capacity is given here 21,600. 21,600 divided by PE is equal to 3024 raised to 3. Right. So therefore, from that you can find it is 364.43 million revolutions. Million revolutions. Now L50 life. Okay, so L50 is equal to, you know that, the 5 into L10. So therefore 5 into 364.43. so therefore we can say L50 life is equal to 1822.157 million revolutions. Okay, so this is our answer. Now next example, for SKF 6207 bearing is to operate on following work cycle. Radial load of 6307 Newton at 200 rpm for 25% of time. Radial load of 9080 Newton at 600 rpm for 20% of time, and radial load of 3638 Newton at 400 rpm for 55% of time. Okay, the inner ring rotates. The loads are steady. Find expected average life of this bearing in hours if dynamic load capacity C is equal to 25,500 Newton. Okay, now here element number 1. So therefore we can say N1 is equal to 6307, N2 is equal to 90880, and N3 is equal to 3638 Newton. Okay, so here element times are given. Here load, that is the P1, P2 and P3. Now speed is n1, n2, and n3. Okay, n1, n2, and n3. These three. Okay, and element speed revolutions 50, 120, and 220. So now three elements are there. So for that, the equation for the equivalent bearing load is PE. You know that PE is equal to cube root of P1 cube N1 plus P2 cube N2 plus P3 cube N3 divided by N1 plus N2 plus N3. Okay. Now, put the value in this equation. So, therefore, cube root of P1 is equal to 6307 cube into N1 is equal to element speed, okay, revolution. So 50, we have to take this speed, element speed, revolution in 50, okay, plus P2 9080 cube into N2 120, okay, so 120 plus P3 3638 cube into 220, this value 220 divided by, okay, 50 plus 120 plus 220. Okay, so from that you can find the value of equivalent bearing load. PE is equal to, okay, by solving this you can see 6616.578 Newton. Okay, you will find the equivalent bearing load. Now let us find the life, okay, life of the bearing. So equation for the life of the bearing, L is equal to, you know that, the C by PE raised to P. Okay, so therefore is equal to, C is equal to already given 25,500. PE we have find 6,616.578 raised to 3. So therefore you can find the value of life is equal to 57.24 million revolution. MR means million revolution. Okay, now let us find the L10 life. Okay, so first of we have find the L10. Now LH is equal to L into 10 raised to 6 divided by 60 into N. Okay, so put the value L is equal to, we have find 57.24, okay, into 10 raised to 6 divided by 60 into total N, 390. Okay, total N is equal to 390. Okay, because 50 plus 120 plus 220, 390. So therefore we can say rating life is equal to 24, okay, is equal to 2446.27 hours. This is the rating life. And average life, okay, average life is equal to 5 into 2446.27. So therefore it is 12,231.35 hours. Okay, so this is our answer. So now I hope you can understand how to find the life of the bearing and how to solve the different examples of the bearing. Okay. So thank you, friends. Thank you very much.